outro jump start a car. Um aterite because eu left the ligt zone, the case in the ignition, or your battery is old, most car owners will be faced with a dead battery sooner or later. Fortunately, if 3 anos ter funcional car nearby, or if you have a manual transmission, you can jump start the car and be on the move again so. Jumping the battery. Open as cars ou dando look at the battery. Almost cars, it will be near the front of the car on the right or left side, but on some cars the battery is located near the firewall between the engine and passenger compartment. In some cars the battery is located in the trunk. If unsure, check your car manual for location of the battery. Identify the positive and negative terminals. T positive terminal will be marked with a plus sign mais, and will usually have a red cable attached on it. T negative terminal will be marked with a minus sign, and will usually have a black cable attached to it. Park the working car near, but not touching, the disabled car. Park the car in such a way that the distance between both car batteries is as small as possible. Turn off the engine, radio, lights, AC, fans and all other electrical components. Make sure that all of the settings are off in the disabled car, too. Don't let the car stall at all. If the cars are touching, jumping the battery can cause a dangerous electrical arc between the vehicles. Put on safety gear, goggles and gloves, if you have it. Inspect baterias for cracks, leaks or tear damage. If you find any of the settings, do not jump start the car. Call a tow truck instigator replace the battery. It might be necessary to remove the disabled automobile's battery cables from the battery terminals and clean both cables and terminals. Use a stiffer brush to remove all corrosion. Reconnect the cables to the battery terminals and jump the car. Remove any positive mais, red post protective covers if applicable. Untangle and unwind your jumper cables. Leak your battery, your jumper cables will probably have red and black cables and will have heavy duty clamps to connect to the battery terminals. You must make sure that the red and black and off your jumper cables never touch as you ter on set air connected to the batteries, permitting tanto do su can result in serious arcing and, or damage to on your boat cars. Connect the jumper cables in the order described below. Connect on red clamp to the positive mais, terminal of the dead battery. Connect the other red clamp to the positive mais, terminal of the good battery. Connect on black clamp to the negative, terminal of the good battery. Connect the other black clamp to a piece of grounded metal on the dead car. Preferably the bolt or the thick negative cable from the battery connects to the chassis. If this is not practical, look for shiny metal, not painted orally, that is attached to the engine. Usually a nut, bolt or the protruding shiny metal will work. You might see a small spark when you connect to a good ground. As a last resort, you might connect to the negative. Post off the dead battery, but this risks igniting hydrogen gas coming off the battery. Make sure none of the cables are dangling into the engine compartment, where they could be exposed moving parts. Start the working car. Let it idle for a few minutes. Do not rush the engine, but do have the engine a little above idle for 30 to 60 seconds. You do this to charge the battery in the dead car, because the starter in the dead car will draw most of the required current, well in excess of 100 amps, from that battery, not through the cables. Como retail jumper cables are not built to pass the current required. Charging the dead battery is a must. If 30 seconds doesn't do it, try charging for the full 60 seconds be keeping the engine at a idle. A good client connection between the battery cables and the battery terminals is essential. Try to start the disabled vehicle. If it does not start, shoot the engine off and disconnect the last connection temporarily will also slightly twist or wiggle as of the four clamps to help ensure a good electrical connection. Restart the working car again. Allow another 5 minutes for charging before attempting to start the disabled vehicle. If this does not work after a few trees, you may need to have the car to add or the battery replaced. Remove the jumper cables once the car starts. Do this in the reverse of the order in which they were attached, and don't let any of the cables or clamps loose as other, or dangle into the engine compartment. Disconnect the black clamp from ground the metal on the dead car. Disconnect the black clamp from the negative, terminal of the good battery. Disconnect the red clamp from the positive mais, terminal of the good battery. Disconnect the red clamp from the positive mais, terminal of the dead battery. Replace only positive mais, red post protective covers if applicable. These covers help prevent accidental short-circuiting the battery. Keep the recently disabled car's engine running. Run the car above idle, slightly revved up with your foot on the gas, for 5 minutes until or above idle for 20 minutes before turning it off. This should give the battery a long charge to start the car again. If it does not, you probably have a dead battery or a dingle alternator.